does this sound? Grass clippings in your tea, water in your milk. It's not a mistake. It's food fraud. A new study from the U.S. Pharmacopoeia Convention finds that lots of our favorite foods are watered down or diluted with cheap ingredients. Senior medical correspondent Elizabeth Cohen is here to show us how to spot the fake foods and make smarter choices at the grocery store. Good to see you. How common is this?
You know, we don't know exactly how common, but this group set out and looked at different academic papers and newspaper reports and found that it happens more than you might think, because we just trust that when something says it's lemon juice, that's all there is.
Right.
So they have tons of examples, and we're going to talk about a couple of them right now. So speaking of lemon juice, you buy, you know, those little fake little plastic lemons?
Yes, and they've got I have a couple in my fridge.
Oh, you
right
do?
Now.
Okay. So when you take a look at that, sometimes they found that there are clouding agents in there to give it kind of more of a natural feel. Here's another example. Pepper. Ground up pepper. The what they found in some cases, and I can't say a lot, I can't say a few, but just some cases, there were actually stems of the pepper and like little pieces of from the shaft of the pepper tree or the branch instead of just all peppercorn. For vanilla, what they found is that sometimes it was synthetic. And for ground up coffee, what they found is that it was sometimes mixed with corn, barley, or twigs. And again, I wish I could tell you the brands that did this and how often it is, but I can't tell you. I don't know. We just know that it does happen.
We do want to say thank you to our hand model over there.
Yes, whoever that was, that was beautiful.
So what can we do to keep this out of our pantry to get the most authentic food for our kids and for ourselves?
You just said it, authentic food. Go to the source. For example, why do you need to buy ground pepper when you can grind it yourself? Mm-hmm. So if you just buy the peppercorns, you can see those are peppercorns. There's nothing else in there, and you can grind them up yourselves. Or, you know, go buy a lemon. I know you said you had some of the fake stuff at home.
I do.
I don't mean to diss you, but it's not that hard to
juice a lemon. I think it's expired as well.
Okay, well, that's another story. So, you know, juice your own lemon, and then that way you know what you're getting. For vanilla, this one's a little expensive. You can buy a vanilla bean, slice it, and put the seeds in. Now, that's a little pricey. It's a little bit of a pain in the neck. But if you really want to make sure that you're a real foodie, let's say, and you want all vanilla, that's something else that you can do. Another thing with coffee is you can grind your own coffee. You don't have to buy it ground up. And then you know you're just getting coffee
beans. So there's some simple ways out there to kind of combat this.
You know, it used to be that we all grew our own food, right? Because you knew you were getting the right stuff because it was from your garden.
Yeah.
And you knew the chicken was really chicken because you killed the chicken. Well, most of us don't live that way, but you can try to get back to that as much as possible.
I like the idea of the vanilla.
Yeah, scraping it in there.
Yeah, all right. Yeah. Tastes better too. Elizabeth,
I bet it does.
Thank you.